Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Okay, in this video, I'm going to share to you how I'm going to solve the Cartel profit maximization problem for two firm. Okay, for your information, this tutorial video is the extent from my previous video, where the previous video we use fully alphabet, which is A minus B Q times with Q minus CQ as a equation. Why? In this tutorial, we are going to use 250 minus 4Q times Q minus 10 as a profit maximization problem. And then, okay, then we're going to find the quantity, price and profit for each firm. And then we are going to assume that firm 1 and firm 2 are cheating. Okay, for the first, we're going to find the quantity, price and profit. Okay, for the first, we're going to rewrite the profit function. Okay, so we just rewrite from the given equation. So we expand the equation to 250 with time with Q, so we get 250 Q minus 4Q square and minus 10Q. Okay, then we going to differentiate the profit over with quantity. So we differentiate, we get 250 minus 4 multiply 2, we get 8. And then minus with 10, and then we're going to equal to 0. So we make Q as a subject, so we divide, so we get 240 minus divide with 8, so we get 30. So we, for the each firm, we're going to divide by 2, so we get the quantity. Okay, and then we're going to find the profit. So we rewrite the equation, and then we substitute Q equal to 30. So we solve the equation, so we get the total profit. So for each firm, we're going to divide by 2, so we get 1800 for each firm. Okay, and then for the price, we rewrite the price function from the equation. So the price equal to 250 minus 4Q. So Q as a 30. So 4 multiply 30, we get 120. So the price is 130. Okay, and then we're going to find Q1R. But we're going to assume firm 2 doesn't cheat, because we need to find Q1R, and then we can proceed to find Q2R. So cheat as a Q1R and doesn't cheat for firm 2 as a Q2C, and equal to 15. Okay, we're going to find the quantity. Okay, so we write the profit function, and then we substitute Q, capital Q, as a Q1R plus Q2C into the bracket, while the outside the bracket as a Q1R and Q1R. Okay, and then we're going to expand. So 250 Q1R minus 4 Q1R square, and for Q2C, Q1R minus 10 Q1R. And then we're going to differentiate profit 1R over quantity 1R. So we differentiate, we get 250 minus 8 minus 4 Q2C and minus 10 and equal to 0. Okay, then We're going to bring negative 8 Q1R to the right. So it becomes positive 8 Q1R. So we rewrite the equation, and then 250 minus 10, we get 240. So minus 4 Q2C equal to 8 Q1R. So we bring Q1R to the left. So Q1R, okay, equal to 250 minus 4Q2C, and we divide with 8. So we get, so and then we substitute Q2C equal to 15 divided by 8, and then we get the Q1R. So okay, and then actually we don't need to find the quantity, price and profit for this question, because we just need only Q1R. But if the question asks you if firm 1 cheat and firm 2 doesn't cheat, so the solution will be like this. So I will be just go through. So okay, you just look how I solve this equation. Alright, so I just go through. Okay, we find the price, we find the profit from one, and then we find the profit for firm 2. Okay, and then okay, we get Q1R, and then we're going to find Q2R. Okay, so we find the quantity, we rewrite the profit function, and then we're going to find the we're going to expand the equation. Okay, the capital Q outside the bracket we substitute as a Q2R. Okay, and then we expand the equation, 250 Q2R minus 4Q1R Q2R minus 4Q2R square minus 10Q2R, and then we're going to differentiate the function the profit over quantity of firm 2, and then we get 250 minus 4Q1R minus 8Q2R minus 10 equal to 0. Okay, and then you rewrite the equation. Okay, and then 250 remainder with 10, so we get 240, and then we minus 4Q1R equal to 8Q2R. We bring 8Q2R to the right. Okay, so we make Q2R as a subject, so we divide by 8, and then we're going to substitute Q1R as a 2.5 based on previous calculation. Okay, so we get Q2R. Okay, and then we're going to find the total quantity. Okay, Q1R and plus with Q2R. So we get the total quantity for 1.25. So we just rewrite the Q1R, Q2R and Q. So we just substitute the Q into the price function. So we get price equal to 85, and then we're going to find the profit for firm 1 and firm 2. Okay, we just rewrite the equation, expand the equation. Okay, outside of the bracket for firm 1 we substitute as a Q1R. Okay, and then we're going to substitute Q1R, Q2R. Okay, based on our calculation. Okay, and then we get we solve the equation, we get the profit for firm 1. Okay, and then the profit for firm 2. Okay, we rewrite, and then we substitute the capital Q outside of the brackets a Q2R. So 250 minus 10, we get 240. Then we're going to substitute Q2R as a 18.75 and Q1R as a 2.5. So we solve the equation. So we get the profit for both firm 1 and firm 2. Alright, that's all. Thank you guys for watching. See you in my next video.